when imbalanced dataset problem happens. And we will talk about several solutions, but we'll talk about its theory, and also in the next lectures we'll cover these solutions. When it happens, you can understand it from its name. It occurs when you do not have equally distributed classes. It means that one of the classes has 100 samples and one of the class has 1000 samples, you will face with this problem. And actually it doesn't matter how many classes do you have. If you have a significant gap between class ratios, or if you have significant gap between classes sample numbers, you will have this problem. And this is the case of imbalanced dataset problem. You see that in the red points there are minority class, we call it minority class, and also the others are majority class. Well, you see that the minority class is actually minority, and this is the reason for not getting good accuracy, because your machine learning architecture have a tendency to predict the majority class. And if you do not have these classes equally, you may have this problem. And to understand this problem, I will show you a case that is for my project, and also before that I want to explain some data preparation stage of that project. In GTA Vice City, if you press W, you go to up. Sorry, you go to the front, and if you press C here, S here, you go back then. And also, if you press WD, you go to the right side, right front side, and it goes on like that. And when I collect the data, and my input data was the keyboard comments, and in these keyboard comment I focused on to how to make my car in the game going in a lane with an order. It means that it will obey the rules of traffic, but also it will, if the lines are going to the right side, our car should go to the right side. If it's left, our car should go to the left. And also, for the parts that I crash, I press C. I pressed S and go back to the way again, and then going further again. Well, you can see the application here, and then we will comment on it. Well, the thing that I do in the training, I always collect the data that I'm going forward. So I wasn't aware of imbalanced dataset problem at that times, and also when I crash, I don't always crash, so I rarely go back and go to the way. And you see that I can my car can go in these lines, between these lines. However, when it crashed, it doesn't do anything. For example, my car will now will go out from out of the lines, and you see that it doesn't go back. I get the command to keyboard input instead of convolutional neural network architecture, and then I am now pulling my car to the between lines. So when I run it again after some times, let's see when it happens. Well, now I run it again. Well, it can follow the lines, but it has also problems. But when it goes out of the way, it doesn't come back. Now I took the control of it again. So the reason is there are actually less, there are actually very rare S command in the data. Well, when you press S, when I press S, this was the time that I'm out of the road, but while training I focused on going between lines, so the S is the rare case, and S command in my dataset was about probably only 5% of it was S, and the rest of it, most of it was W, and there are imbalances in there. So the problem that I suffered in this application, when I'm out of the way, I couldn't get between the lines again. So I took the control of it at that stage, and I'm now carrying it to the lines. This is the problem that I first encountered with an imbalanced dataset. And also, we will talk about the case that we will face with imbalanced dataset problem, and it's on PyCharm. We will talk about it, but before that, let's see some solutions to this problem. What are the solutions for imbalanced dataset problem? Well, it means that it's imbalanced and we need to balance it to not face again with imbalanced data problem. And to do that, we need to equalize the classes, or we need to equalize the effect of the classes in convolutional neural networks or in any architecture, and we will do it by adding some parameters to the loss function. However, the easy solution that we can do is adding some points to the minority class and make them equal. Even if you do apply the same data set, same minority class, if you copy and paste the same minority class, it will affect in a good way. So you will have a problem due to the less variance. However, you will get a better accuracy when it's compared to these unbalancedness. Well, actually, the best solution is adding the data to your data set, and the data that you should add should be must be minority class, and you should equalize them. Well, actually, in machine learning, the area that works with numeric data, you have less solution when it's compared to the convolutional neural network. I think it's strange because you work with image in convolutional, you mostly work with image in convolutional neural networks. However, you get better solutions with generating synthetic data. Well, you see that you can balance it. So to equalize the classes, you can reduce the number of samples of minority class, or you can oversample the minority class, and also you can do oversampling with the data that you have. Maybe you cannot, you don't able to collect, you aren't able to collect data because it's like a spam example. There are no spam meals in your data set, for example. There are very less number of spam emails, and you can't even collect one, and there are cases like that. And also, you can random oversample it or random upsample it. And also, I probably should change them with oversample and undersample. I'm sorry about it. However, this is a solution for machine learning algorithms. And also, there is another method for machine learning. Actually, there are lots of methods, but these are not as successful as the methods that we do in convolutional neural networks. And we should create a generic data in any case, or we should collect the data to balance it and also to increase the variance of our data set. But creating a generic data is actually image augmentation for the convolutional neural networks, and I put the link of classifying plankton. You have 20 images per class in this dataset. Per class in this dataset, even at that situation, you get a good accuracy. And the creating generic data is image augmentation for the convolutional neural networks. Or let's get back to this image, and let's say that why don't we tell to the convolutional neural network architecture that minority class is important? How to do that? Actually, answering this question goes to the reason of this problem. It's clear to see the reason of imbalanced dataset problem while looking into the formula of loss. It's actually the reason is your loss function will see lots of examples, lots of samples of the minority class, and it will have a tendency to your neural network architecture or your machine learning architecture will have a tendency to predict always the minority class. And let's answer this intuitively. And assume we have two classes, class 1 and class 2. And class 1 over class 2 ratio is 9,900 to 100. And let's say we have a loss function. You actually will have a loss function in most of convolutional neural network architectures, in all of machine learning architectures. And when you train it, you see that 9,900 times of correction of prediction of class 1 will happen, because you have 9,900 images for class 1, but also only 100 times of correction of prediction is happens for class 2. Well, how to solve this problem? If you say to your neural network or convolutional neural network or support vector machine, whatever you want, the class 2 and class 1s are not equal, to equalize it, in loss function you should care about the class 2 and you should give importance to it. To do that, now we will reverse the ratios of them, and to avoid imbalanced dataset problem, we will do equation like this: number of all samples minus class 1 minus that class over number of all samples. We can compute the values of it, and then when we multiply it with the classes, we will get equal. We will equalize our dataset in a theoretic way. So let's say that we calculated them, and you see that 9,900 multiplied by 0.01 is 99. And also, if you calculate the class 2 that has less data when it's compared to class 1, and if you compute it, you see that you have 0.99. And if you calculate its value, you see that you calculate its actually class weights. And in your class weights, in your calculations, you have theoretically you have a balance of data. So with that way, you can have better results when it's compared to when it's compared to the imbalanced dataset case.